The New Age religion, folks, is going to have a worldwide leader, a charismatic political and religious leader that they call Lord Maitreya. At least so far, that's who they call him, or that's what they call him. This individual, as far as I know, has not made his public appearance yet, but the New Agers claim that he is on the earth at the present time. They claim that he came to live with the Asian community in East London, England, in July 1977 by descending from his ancient retreat in the Himalaya Mountains along the border of India and Tibet. They further believe that his imminent emergence into full public view is assured. They also claim that this individual is the one that the Christians call Christ, the Jews call the Messiah, the Buddhists call the fifth Buddha, the Hindus call Krishna, and the Muslims call the Imam Mahdi. In other words, all of the major religions of the world are awaiting the arrival of this one individual. And they say that he is on the earth now, patiently waiting for the appointed time to reveal his existence to the peoples of the world. They say that he will apparently assume the leadership of all of these religions, and when he does, he will create a one-world religion. The New Agers have written that in the esoteric tradition, previously defined as being intended for or understood by only a chosen few as an inner group of disciples or initiates, in other words, the esoteric means hidden. They claim that the word Christ is not the name of an individual, but the name of an office or function within the spiritual hierarchy of masters. They claim that the masters are a group of perfected men who have guided human evolution from behind the scenes for centuries, and they believe that this Lord Maitreya is that Christ. Now, Manly P. Hall has written of this individual by identifying him as, quote, the way, the truth, and the life, which coming to every life redeems all who accept it, unquote.
Freemasonry, for example, is one of the ways that people are systematically brought to the point where it is revealed to them that Lucifer is in fact God. This deception is based on the fact that initially Masons believe that what they're involved in is in fact Christian.
Lucifer, what is your problem?
Just that, sir.
Okay.
I'm a Christian, sir.
I'm pure and virtuous and wholesome and innocent. How can you say anything about me?
Sir, you need to be born again.
I am born again.
Now, did you just say that you are Lucifer?
I am Lucifer.
Okay, define Lucifer for me.
Pure, virtuous, wholesome, innocent individual that's out to help people.
Lucifer is?
Yeah.
Say that again. Lucifer is a pure, holy...
Virtuous.
Virtuous. Now, see the Lucifer that God created?
That's the same one.
Oh, man, this is great. I'm going to put this on the internet.
Oh,
amen.
God bless you,
amen.
Brother.
Because that's exactly what the Shriners and Masons teach, is that Lucifer is light.
No.
And you're,
hey, what
you're
about
confirming
those hospitals?
You know, sir? Jesus said, many will say to me on that day, Lord, Lord, did we not do these good deeds in your name? And you'll say, away from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you.
Jesus said it?
In Matthew chapter 5.
Mercy.
No.
That's hard to believe.
So you're a Christian and you don't know that? Actually.
No, I really am.
You are.
Because I'm pure and virtuous.
You're pure and virtuous, okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, you're perfect without Jesus, right?
No.
Okay, tell me about Jesus. Who is Jesus?
Oh. Well, he's my leader.
Is he the Son of God?
Yes, he is.
Is he the only worshipful master?
Yes.
Have you ever been called worshipful master?
No, because I've just been too busy. I've been working.
Working.
Been working to help people.
What
like
kind
you.
Of work?
Okay. Get out of here.
See, this is what a Mason confesses, is that Lucifer is light.
One of the former leaders of the Theosophical Society, who was contemporary with Blavatsky and Annie Besant, tells us what the 19th century position on Satan is. In his work, Spiritualism, Madame Blavatsky and Theosophy, Rudolf Steiner states, quote, Lucifer is not a being that we can see with our present-day physical eyes. Lucifer can be seen only with the awakened clairvoyance. Seen clairvoyantly, in fact, Lucifer is a particular being who was left behind during the moon phase of evolution. End of quote. N. Sri Ram, who often gave lectures at the United Nations, who himself is a major theosophist and was a writer for Lucifer magazine, clarifies, quote, the adversary or Satan is no other than Lucifer, the light bearer, the bright morning star. He is the initiator, awakening the divine faculties of intellect on man. He is the king of the fallen angels, spirits from higher spheres, who descended among primitive mankind of the third race, to develop in man and endow him with his self-conscious mind or manas. End of quote.
My friends, there is a counterfeit Christ, an antichrist, being birthed in the time we live in. All of these rituals are all leading towards the same thing, the sex magic ritual of birthing this beast from the sea or abyss. This is the counterfeit. Rise out of the abyss. The crucifixion of the phoenix. The offering of Cain that will not be acceptable before the Father. This goes under the name of Sananda. This image we've been fed of Jesus Christ for so many years has had a reason, a purpose, because this is the counterfeit Antichrist. In the day and age that we live in, they even have written the new gospel according to Sananda, which they are passing off as the same Jesus that lived 2,000 odd years ago. My friends, this is a complete lie. This is the book that turns your stomach sour, as Revelation describes. This is the false gospel. This is the gospel of the deliverance of Ra, the sun god, the black sun, the return of Cain to slay his brother Abel. Those of us in Christ are the body of Christ, quite literally. And Cain will return to once again, just like the story at the very beginning of Genesis, will return to slay his brother. But my friends, the offering that Cain provides is perishable. It's the fruits of the soil. It's death. They will perish. It's the manna that perishes in the desert. You're standing in the face of every religion across the world that is expecting this figure to rise. Every cult, every religion, every belief system, including Christianity, which has been deceived on many levels because they've been told a false slant on a lot of things to feed into exactly the same agenda.
Close on Sunday, you my Chick-fil-A. Close on Sunday, you my Chick-fil-A. Hold the selfies, put the gram away. Get your family, y'all hold hands and pray. When you got daughters, always keep them safe. Watch out for vipers, don't let them indoctrinate.
I sold my soul to the devil. I know it's a crappy deal. Lisa came with a few toys like a Happy Meal.
John Gray and Avinder Gray are going to be your pastors. And I really believe that John and Avinder have always been anointed. But the anointing that is going to fall on them now that they're senior pastors is going to do amazing damage to the kingdom of God. Amazing damage.
Amazing damage.
Amazing damage to the kingdom of God. So I'm excited about that.
The Pope participated in the virtual event to celebrate International Day of Human Fraternity. The United Nations designated this day petitioned by the United Arab Emirates to commemorate the day the Pope and the leader of the Sunni Muslims, Ahmed Al-Tayeb, signed the document on human fraternity 2 years ago. A special committee was created to promote the document's message. Judge and committee member Abdel Salam led the online event. The Grand Imam said this day should act as a reminder of the need for a more united world. He and the Pope praised each other's courage in pushing this initiative forward.
Lo más lindo de todo que ese primer deseo de fraternidad se fue consolidando en verdadera fraternidad. Gracias, hermano. Gracias.
Pope Francis's message was very clear. He said it's not a time for indifference, and that the only valid option is fraternity.
No podemos decir o hermanos o no hermanos. Digamos más bien o hermanos o enemigos.
He also said fraternity does not mean rejecting one's own ideas or roots, but rather listening to, accepting, and counting on one another.
Fraternidad quiere decir firmeza en las propias convicciones, porque no hay verdadera fraternidad si se negocian las propias convicciones. Somos hermanos, nacidos de un mismo padre, con culturas y tradiciones diferentes, pero todos hermanos.
The winners of the Zayed Prize, inspired by the document on human fraternity, were also announced during the event. They were UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres.
Theosophy teaches that Lucifer is actually a divine being that saves mankind and brings him consciousness. Many modern-day New Agers who are deceived by Theosophy repeat the same theme. For example, David Spangler admits that Lucifer is a being that New Agers honor and that the light of Lucifer is the light of God. Quote, he says, "The true light of Lucifer cannot be seen through sorrow, through darkness, or through rejection. The true light of this great being can only be recognized when one's own eyes can see with the light of the Christ, the light of the inner sun. Lucifer works within each of us, trying to bring us to wholeness as we move into the new age, which is the age of man's wholeness. Each of us in some way is brought to that point, which I term the Luciferic initiation. The particular doorway through which the individual must pass if he is to come fully into the presence of his light with his wholeness. Lucifer comes to give us the final gift of wholeness if we accept it, that he is free and we are free. This is the Luciferic initiation. It is one that many people now and in the days ahead will be facing, for it is an initiation into the new age. It is an initiation of leaving the past and moving into the new, shedding our guilt and fears, our anxieties, our needs, our temptations, and becoming whole and at peace because we have recognized our inner light, the light that unfolds us, the light of God." End of quote. We can now therefore conclude that Luciferian doctrine is fused into the New Age movement through Theosophy. Along with this doctrine is the belief that because of Satan, man will now evolve spiritually and intellectually, conquer the world, conquer nature, and become a god. Now, here is an admission that Freemasonry is aimed at creating God-men, just as Hitler wanted to do. The purpose of initiation in Freemasonry is to attain godhood. Quote, "The height of the lodge, even as high as the heavens, implies that the range of consciousness possible to us when we have developed our potentialities to the full is infinite. Man, who has sprung from the earth and developed through the lower kingdoms of nature to his present rational state, has yet to complete his evolution by becoming a godlike being and unifying his consciousness with the omniscient, to promote which is and always has been the sole aim and purpose of all initiation." End of quote. Maitreya and Benjamin Krem. Benjamin Krem claims that in 1959 he was contacted by the Ascended Masters, asking him if he wanted to be a forerunner for the coming New Age Christ Maitreya. He became the official mouthpiece for who he called Lord Maitreya. According to Krem, in 1977 Maitreya made his first physical appearance. Benjamin Krem sees himself as a contemporary to John the Baptist in the Bible. He heads up an organization called Share International. And if you look at the website, it says, "In the midst of war, fear and famine, new hope is in the world for us all." Also on the website, he has a little article. It's entitled "The Master's Latest Article." And it says this, quote, "Under the wise guidance of the Christ and his brothers, man will attain the full stature of revealed divinity, which is his birthright, did he but know it. Stage by stage, century following century, man will build a civilization which will demonstrate his growing manifestation of divinity, a culture in which the beauty of the divine creation will be expressed in all its aspects, a mirror in which the divine idea will be reflected in all its glory." End of quote. Now, who is Maitreya? Benjamin Krem says that he has been expected for generations by all of the major religions. He says Christians know him as the Christ and expect his imminent return. Jews await him as the Messiah. Hindus look for the coming of Krishna. Buddhists expect him as Maitreya Buddha. And Muslims anticipate the Imam Mahdi or Messiah. He says although the names are different, many believe that they all refer to the same individual, the world teacher, whose personal name is Maitreya. Preferring, he says, to be known simply as the teacher, Maitreya has not come as a religious leader or to found a new religion, but as a teacher and a guide for people of every religion and even of those who have no religion. At this time of great political, economic and social crisis, Maitreya will inspire humanity to see itself as one family and create a civilization based on sharing, economic and social justice and global cooperation. He will launch a call to action to save the millions of people who starve to death every year in a world of plenty. Among Maitreya's recommendations will be a shift in social priorities so that adequate food, housing, clothing, education, and medical care become universal rights. He's actually describing socialism.
Well, hello, folks. Here we are today on Mount Carmel, the Mount Carmel, where Elijah faced off the prophets of Baal. And on the Mount Carmel is a shrine, a temple that is prayed to by millions across the world. Those of the Baha'i faith pray to this tomb, which is shrouded in symbolism which we are very, very familiar with. This religion has many similarities to the New World Order, Alice Bailey, Theosophical Society doctrine. In fact, the word Bab means gate. So what we're really looking at here is a gateway to the Luciferian New Age. And just with the same kind of observations, a symbolism all over this place. I mean, it's almost like the shrine itself is a hive. You know, the hive on the dome with the pyramid and the star gate in the center of the pyramid, you know, and glaringly obvious pentagrams around the base there. So let's go through some of the doctrine of the Baha'i faith. And as you can see here, the crown with the light representing the illumination. This is all symbolic of the Sun King, the coming of the Antichrist.
Now, under Maitreya's inspiration, humanity itself, he says, will make the required changes and create a saner and a more just world for all. So, you know, Maitreya is going to come to improve the world at every level. Now, Krem and other occultists have often claimed that Maitreya would manifest at certain times or dates. All their prophecies have failed, and according to Deuteronomy 18:22, it says that when a prophet speaks in the name of the Lord, if the thing does not come about or come true, that is the thing which the Lord then has not spoken. This prophet has spoken it presumptuously, and you shall not be afraid of him. So obviously we have to regard Benjamin Krem as a false prophet.
La mayor parte de los habitantes del planeta se declaran creyentes. Esto debería provocar un diálogo entre las religiones. No debemos dejar de orar por él y colaborar con quienes piensan distinto.
Confío en Buda.
Creo en Dios.
Creo en Jesucristo.
Creo en Dios, Allah.
Muchos piensan distinto, sienten distinto, buscan a Dios o encuentran a Dios de diversa manera. En esta multitud, en este abanico de religiones, hay una sola certeza que tenemos para todos. Todos somos hijos de Dios.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Confío en vos para difundir mi petición de este mes. Que el diálogo sincero entre hombres y mujeres de diversas religiones conlleve frutos de paz y justicia. Confío en tu oración.
Now, since Jiddu Krishnamurti failed as the world teacher and who was supposedly responsible for ushering in the age of Aquarius one world system, theosophists, Freemasons and occultists have been waiting now for their world teacher since then. On January the 9th, 1959, Benjamin Krem claims that powerful spiritual forces came into contact with him to elicit his help in announcing the arrival of Maitreya as the world teacher to humanity. Krem started an organization called Share International, which is aimed at promoting Maitreya, Theosophy and the New Age. Krem admits that he was influenced by Blavatsky and Bailey. He says, quote, "To many today, this awareness includes the recognition of higher states of consciousness attained by those who make up the emerging spiritual kingdom, the masters and initiates of the world. Their existence was first revealed in modern times by H.P. Blavatsky, co-founder of the Theosophical Society, as long ago as 1875. He goes on to say, a more detailed communication about the masters and their work was given by Alice Bailey between 1919 to 1949. In her book, The Externalization of the Hierarchy, she revealed the existence of a planned return to physical plane work and activity by this group of enlightened men, which return, I submit, has already begun." End of quote. These people are claiming that their secret doctrines and inspirations for their writings come from what they call ascended masters. However, the Bible states that the dark side of the spirit realm is ruled by Satan, who is the prince of darkness, and demons, and the father of lies. Both Satan and his demonic forces present themselves as angels of the kingdom of light, or the kingdom of God, thereby deceiving people. Although the writings and claims of these occultists can be very detailed and even sound authoritative, there is absolutely no proof of the claims they make. The same doctrines of demons simply get passed on from one person to another until they are all singing from the same page. These dark spirits mimic the Bible as much as possible. Just as the New Age prophets claim that Maitreya is in fact the Christ that the world is waiting for, and that Benjamin Krem is the forerunner of this Christ, as was John the Baptist of the Christ in the Bible, they even claim that Maitreya's star has now appeared. This is a counterfeit of the Star of Bethlehem, for example, that heralded the birth of Jesus Christ in the Bible. They claim that what they call starlight luminaries will appear in the four quadrants of the earth.
The the Lord, Maitreya is awaited by Christians as the Christ, although they don't know it, is awaited by Hindus as Krishna, although they don't know it, is awaited by Jews as the Messiah, although they don't know it, is awaited by Muslims as the Imam Mahdi, although they don't know it, and awaited by Buddhists who have his name right, as Maitreya Buddha, foretold to come now by the previous Buddha, Gautama Buddha, who said at this time would come into the world a great teacher, a Buddha like himself, who from his great spiritual stature would stimulate and galvanize, inspire humanity to create a brilliant golden civilization based, as he put it, on righteousness and truth. But on the day of declaration, they will absolutely not miss it. On the day of declaration, which will be arranged, of course, a certain day, when enough people are responding and demanding that we let this man speak to the whole world. He's already well known, been on media all over the world, and people are clamoring to hear him speak to the world as a whole, thinking he's the Imam Mahdi or Krishna or Maitreya Buddha or the Christ or whatever, the Messiah. Whatever they think, all these names apply to him, but he doesn't like them. He says, if I'm the Christ to Christians, well, what about the Jews? What about the Hindus? What about the Muslims? If I'm Krishna to the Hindus, well, what about the others? Where do they come in? If I'm Maitreya Buddha, which of course he is, they're the only one who have got his name right. If I'm Maitreya Buddha, well, what about the Christians? What about the Hindus? What about the Buddhists? Jews and so on. So he wants only to be called the teacher. On the day of declaration, to get back to that, he will, I don't know how long it will take, maybe 30 minutes, 35 minutes, something, 40 minutes, something like that. He will not speak, not say a word, but his thoughts, his ideas will be heard inwardly, telepathically, by everybody in the world, everybody above the age of 14. So if you're 14, you're Slovenian, you'll hear him in Slovenian. If you're Russian, you'll hear him in Russian. Americans in American, English in English, French in French, Dutch in Dutch, and so on. He will give a kind of account of the long history of humanity, show how old we are, from what a height, a spiritual height we have descended into this materiality of today, endangering the very future of the species, and at the same time showing the future, what it can be like if we just accept that we are brothers, that we are brothers and sisters of one humanity. We can create a civilization based on that, which will take us, as he puts it, to the very stars. And the masters will give to humanity their insight, their wisdom, their age-old wisdom and experience and knowledge, and stimulate and galvanize humanity into creating the most brilliant civilization. While this is going on, his energy, which we call the Christ principle, the energy of love, will flow out in tremendous potency throughout the world. He said it will be as if I embrace the world. People will feel it even physically. And at the same time, and this will create an inner certainty that this is the Christ, an intuitive understanding of the message, a heartfelt response to the message. And on the physical plane, there will be hundreds of thousands of spontaneous miracle cures, healings all over the planet. And in these three ways, you will know that one is the Christ, the world teacher, the Imam Mahdi, the Messiah, Maitreya Buddha, Krishna, by whatever name you await him, you will know that one has come and beginning his outer mission in the world.
It is claimed that his manifestation will come just after a global economic meltdown. It is also claimed that Maitreya wants the world to share resources in order to eliminate inequality in the world. He is going to be all things to all men, it seems, and unite the world's religions. The Bible says that when the Antichrist appears, he will do so with great signs and wonders that will deceive many, many people. So this New Age Maitreya is already taking credit for all kinds of alleged spiritual signs and wonders. Benjamin Krem also claims that UFO sightings will increase before the manifestation of Maitreya, and that Maitreya will be able to explain UFOs.
Perhaps we need some outside universal threat to make us recognize this common bond. I occasionally think how quickly our differences worldwide would vanish if we were facing an alien threat from outside this world. And yet, I ask you, is not an alien force already among us?
You're trying to give me a hint that there are aliens.
No, I'm trying to tell you I don't know.
Oh.
But if we were visited someday, I wouldn't be surprised. I just hope that it's not like Independence Day.
Yeah, right. Really,
that it's a conflict.
Well, now we have friendly
maybe
aliens.
The only way to unite this incredibly divided world of ours. They're out there. We better think of how all the differences among people on Earth would seem small if we felt threatened by a space invader. That's the whole theory of independence.
You're right. You're
everybody
right.
Everybody gets together and makes nice and, you know.
The U.S. Navy has finally acknowledged that videos appearing to show UFOs flying through the air are real. They don't call them UFOs. They call them unidentified aerial phenomena. The several videos they're talking about were recorded years ago by fighter pilots. Then in 2017, they were made public by the New York Times. More now from our Randy Kay.
It's rotating.
Images of that rotating thing captured by U.S. Navy aircraft. Sensors locking in on the target. Commander David Fravor saw it firsthand during a training mission, describing it like a 40-foot-long tic-tac, maneuvering rapidly and changing direction.
As we both looked out the right side of our airplane, we saw a disturbance in the water and a white object, oblong, pointing north.
The object was first sighted in 2004, then similar objects again in 2015. Footage of the sightings, declassified by the military, weren't made public until December 2017 by the New York Times and a group that researches UFOs.
There's a whole fleet of them. Look on the ASA. My gosh. They're all going against the wind. The wind's 120 knots to the west. The whole thing, dude.
This was extremely abrupt, like a ping pong ball bouncing off a wall. The ability to hover over the water and then start a vertical climb from basically zero up towards about 12,000 feet and then accelerate in less than 2 seconds and disappear is something I had never seen in my life.
The Navy says it still doesn't know what the objects are, and officials aren't speculating. A Navy spokesman simply confirming to CNN the objects seen in the various clips are unidentified aerial phenomena, or UAPs.
The UFO reports were first investigated by a secret $22 million program, part of the Defense Department budget, that investigated reports of UFOs. The program has since been shut down, but it was run by a military intelligence official who told CNN they found compelling evidence that we, quote, may not be alone. Randy Kay, CNN, New York.
The future.
Welcome to Texaco. You can trust your car to the system with the star. Checking oil. Checking landing gear.
Shark still looks fake.
Want to tell the Rebbe the words of the new song that we're singing with Mashiach, right? So I'm just going to read them. Am Yisrael, have no fear. Mashiach will be here this year. We want Mashiach now. We don't want to wait. Okay?
What does this gospel according to Sananda say? Much blood has been spilled in the name of his glorious and wondrous Emmanuel, and it is to be before this cycle ends that it shall be vindicated. Emmanuel Esu, the one you erroneously called Jesus Christ, shall be vindicated from attachment to such actions, for his teachings were never such. He cares not what you call his person, he cares greatly what ye attribute unto his person. This beloved one has grown into his full stature in the heavenly lineage, and has attained his inheritance and patrimony, his oneness with God, Aten, and his rightful place of purity within the creation as creator. He is soon returning unto your planet, that he might fulfill his commission, and thus we are preparing the way for that coming. Ye have been sent before him that these things in these days be completed and set to order. O blessed ones, ye shall be soon given the proof for which ye plead, for the hourglass is all but run out. My friends, this is the offering that is perishable. This is not the true offering. This is the offering of Cain, and the Father will not accept it. Again, as this counterfeits everything that Christ did, it also counterfeits the transfiguration, where Christ became connected as a bridge to the Father. The transfiguration means a complete change of form or appearance into a more beautiful or spiritual state. The gospel according to Sananda, during the transfiguration of the planet, will be removed, lifted into another world, until the events of your mother planet, to which many of you will return as ascended masters, have been completed.
Mormons having their own planet. This is one of my favorite subjects because, according to the Book of Mormon musical, Mormons are very excited because we get to have our own planet someday.
I believe that plan involves me getting my own planet.
This is all lies. Concurrent with the events of society, the polar shift is happening in the core of the Earth, wherefrom the new Earth is emerging. This is the same as the Golden Age. This is the same as the New World Order. It's all the same thing feeding into this agenda. While the old Earth is falling back into a lower vibration, like a caterpillar that transfigures into a butterfly, throws off the cocoon. It is sometimes just like a flick of a switch that can bring you into the knowing that you have come so far to awaken, and it is time to focus on the joy and the love that is swelling within you. Love shall be the whole of the law, Aleister Crowley, and to leave the old remnants of yesterday's heartaches and worries where they are cleared and transformed into beautiful notions of splendor as you step forward to mark your new life amongst us in creation mode. This is the figure. This is the false Christ.
Quoting from a book called The Hidden Dangers of the Rainbow by Constance Cumby, it says, "When the advent of a single world religion annoy the hierarchies of all the current Orthodox religions?" I asked. "More than that," Krem said with a smile, "they will be shocked. I dare say they will be among the last to accept the Christ." But according to Kissling, Krem said confidently, "It will come because it must. We will begin to live," he said, "as potential gods." End of quote. I said previously that the occultists claim that they get their inspiration from otherworldly beings, from spirit beings. They understand that these are fallen spirit beings that are on the dark side, but of course they believe that that's the good side because they invert what the Bible teaches, that what the Bible describes as the kingdom of darkness, they believe is the kingdom of light, or Lucifer's kingdom, and that God's kingdom of light is the kingdom of darkness. So it's just inverted, and they give names to these otherworldly beings or the spirit guides or ascended masters. And this website speaks of guidance from our elder brothers and sisters, and they describe them as off-earth allies and give these entities, these spiritual entities, names. So here we see Anubis, Arctan, derisum, and these are made up, no doubt about that, you know. But what is interesting is that Osiris, for example, and Anubis are Egyptian deities that come out of the occult. So we see the link with Egyptology and Freemasonry and occult teachings. Now bear in mind that this is consistent with what Manly P. Hall, a high-level occultist, claimed, that the New World Order would be governed by spirit beings that he claims are superior to humans, because humans cannot even govern themselves. And here we can clearly see that this thinking is reinforced, and they are truly looking to these dark, demonic spiritual entities for guidance to solve the world's problems. Now, it is not only New Agers and occultists who believe in this Maitreya, but also politicians, presidents, and elitists. Wayne Peterson, a retired American diplomat and admitted supporter of Maitreya with connections to the Pentagon and the United States, stated the following about Mikhail Gorbachev in a magazine called Vision Magazine in an interview on the June 20th, 2000. He says, "I believe Mikhail Gorbachev has publicly stated his belief in the existence of Maitreya. Do you know if this is true?" Wayne Peterson says, "I have one little story I could tell you about Gorbachev. A friend of mine who was working with the World Bank went to a heads of state conference in Europe and gave a speech where he borrowed many of Maitreya's ideas for economic reform out of a book by Benjamin Krem that I'd given him. He told me that he had read the book on his flight to Europe and realized that his keynote address to these world officials, especially presidents and prime ministers, was after all a very high-level meeting, was going to be very boring, with many having heard similar sentiments over and over. So he thought he would throw in some of Maitreya's ideas into his speech. The country he was in had a reigning monarch who invited him to lunch the next day. When he showed up for lunch, there were 16 to 20 people there, including Mr. Gorbachev. The monarch of this country said to him, 'My friend, I suppose you're wondering why we invited you here today. Well, we are all curious about where you got those ideas for your speech, which you presented yesterday.' He said that my friend Wayne gave me a book written by Benjamin Krem about Maitreya's mission. Immediately they nodded their heads. 'Well, we thought so,' was the apparent response. 'That's why we invited you here. We all know of Maitreya and we're doing what we can for him, but we are not able to say anything publicly because we are world leaders. We each have our own public to deal with.' Only one person there stood up and said that they could use his name to legitimize these sightings, and that was Mikhail Gorbachev. He was the only man in the room who would say, 'Use my name if you want.' The next question was, 'Do you think President Clinton has had any experience of Maitreya?' Wayne Peterson replies, 'I don't know if President Clinton has. I believe that former President George Bush has. We used to have transmission meditation groups that Maitreya had asked us to do around Washington, D.C. People who were interested in Maitreya and the reappearance story would get together once a week in Georgetown and in the home of President Bush's main counselor at the White House. President Bush came over to this house for dinner one night, and the hostess was in the dining room as President Bush asked her, 'What do you think? I'm running against Clinton in this election. Am I going to win?' She said, 'No, Mr. President, you are not. Maitreya has already said you are going to lose to Clinton.' Bush never challenged her, but merely said, 'Yeah, yeah.' He didn't ask who Maitreya was. He was very quiet and then said, 'I think I've got to go now.' Now, Benjamin Krem said many times that he had heard from one of Maitreya's associates that Maitreya had appeared to Bush and that they had had discussions in the White House. So that incident with my meditation group seemed to confirm that Bush did in fact know of Maitreya. I do know people in the White House have been visited by Maitreya many times, and the people I'm talking about I've seen on the front page of the Washington Post standing next to the president.
I think even that does not describe why the world has changed so much and why the world has turned so much toward a new world order and a new kind of civilization."
Now, the United Nations, Lucis Trust, World Goodwill, and Theosophy are all going out of their way to promote Maitreya, the New Age Christ and Savior of the world. They claim that Jesus was only a disciple of Maitreya. Jesus, they say, heralded in the astrological age of Pisces. Now the new age is going to herald in the age of Aquarius, which includes a new world order, a new civilization of God-men, and the savior of the world, Maitreya. Jesus and the old age of Christianity, which is now perceived as outdated and irrelevant to a postmodern society, is to be seen as something of the past. The new thing is Maitreya, and the new age spirituality that openly declares that Lucifer is God and that we are gods.
Now, oil used to fly airlines,
right?
But it, even back mm-hmm. there then, man, mm-hmm. it got to the place where it was agitating his spirit,
sure.
people coming up to him. He right. had become famous and they wanting him to pray for him and right. all that. You can't manage that today.
Right.
This dope-filled world.
Right.
And get in a long tube with a bunch of demons.
Right. That's exactly the
And point. It's deadly.
And
isn't it true that you want to fly commercial so that you can fly in luxury? How much money did you pay for Tyler Perry's Gulfstream jet, for example?
Well, for example, that's really none of your business, but...
Isn't it the business of your donors?
Listen, I paid. You kind of caught me off guard here, okay?
You said that you don't like to fly commercial because you don't want to get into a tube with a bunch of demons. Do you really believe that human beings are demons?
No, I do not. And don't you ever say I did. We wrestle not with flesh and blood, but principalities and powers.
Can you explain what you meant by that, yes. that by that term then? Yes. Just explain, because it's really simple. You said you didn't want to get into a tube with a bunch of demons. What did you mean?
Well, let me ask you.
Do you think that people that fly commercial are demons?
If you give me a chance to talk, sweetheart, I'll explain this to you. But it's a biblical thing. It's a spiritual thing. It doesn't have anything to do with people. People, I love people. Jesus loves people, but people get pushed in alcohol. Do you think that's a good place for a preacher to be and prepare to go preach to a lot of people when somebody in there is dragging some woman down an aisle? It made me so mad to see that on television. I wanted to punch the guy out myself. I can't be doing that while I'm getting ready to preach.
To those critics that say that a preacher should not be living a life of luxury, what is your response to that?
They're wrong.
That's it?
That it's a misunderstanding of the Bible that if you go into the Old Covenant, do you think the Jewish people believe you should be broke?
Are you saying that Jewish people appreciate money more than...
Really? No, they believe in wealth.
Some people would find that offensive.
But when you go back to the Bible, it's full of wealth. And it's full of miracles and signs and wonders. And it's full of goodness and it's full of meanness. It's just full of hell on earth. Those are the demons, not the people. I love the people.
So the transfigure, what did Christ say? He answers and said to them, "When it is evening, ye say it will be fair weather, for the sky is red. And in the morning, it will be foul weather today, for the sky is red and lowering. All ye hypocrites, ye can discern the face of the sky, but can ye not discern the signs of the times?" CERN plays a massive part in this, my friends. The God particle. Why do you think all of this is happening in the day we live in? No one knows what day or hour this will happen. But my friends, we can see the signs of the times all around us. Then what did Christ say? "A wicked and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and there shall be no sign given unto it, but the sign of the prophet Jonah." What is the sign of the prophet Jonah? Jonah went into the whale, into the belly of the beast, into the abyss. I believe what Christ is saying here is the only sign will be given to this adulterous generation that is seeking for a sign will be the sign of the abyss. The belly of the beast on earth. How many people are waiting for this to happen, and this is the only sign they'll get? A lot of the symbolism looks quite Roman, in essence.
Desperate need of truth. Brittle am I, these bones once dry, it's all I ever knew. But I came alive, alive in you. You are the sling, I am the stone, in desperate need of faith. Doubtful in seasons without any reason, forgetting that you saved. And I came alive, alive in you. Oh, I came alive, alive in you. In you. Want my heart and soul, spirit stirring, through me you are working. I see it all, I see it all. You took my life, you've taken control. I just sit back, slinging stone.
Nature, I once was hidden. This one. lady, I give it all, I give it all. You've won my heart and soul. Spirit stirring through me, I'm working. I see it all, I see it all. You took my life, you've taken control. I just sit back, sit back. Slinging stones.